Y'all, the time has come for me to shoot my first music video! You have no idea. This is my favorite song on the whole entire mixtape. It's called Heart Inside a Safe. Now, I know I told y'all that Ballin' was one of my favorite songs on the mixtape, but Heart Inside a Safe takes the cake because there's a deeper message in there. It's about independence. It's about a woman wanting more out of her intimate relationships. And personally, I don't think that there's anything wrong with a woman who wants a man who has goals, who can provide, who is financially stable, who wants to become a better version or the best version of himself. And this is what this song is all about, just being tired with scrubs, just not wanting to deal with men who don't really have anything to offer.
Photo. No. Hi.
Okay.
They kind of just take, and they don't really have anything to give. A lot of what I talk about has either happened to me or I've seen it happen to other people in my music. This song is going to be all about a scrub and just me being so annoyed with the scrub and over him, like, you don't have nothing to offer me. Don't come ask me for no, You know what I'm saying? You need a man who is deserving. And that's what this whole theme is all about. So I'm really excited to talk about the theme of this because I have so many inspirations for it. Now I need to say this. Part of my inspiration is Pamela Anderson. And the reason why I'm so inspired by her is because A, she's from Ontario, Canada, like me.
Are black people in Canada called Canadian African Americans?
I love her style. A huge portion of this is going to be a tribute to Pamela Anderson, but the Kiki way. We're going to call it the key mix because I'm going to come through and I'm putting a little bit of flavor on it. So the outfit is going to be crazy. There's going to be like 3 or 4 outfits, and I'm going early 2000s for some of these looks, and also super sexy and cheeky. Like, I really love light pink, all pinks, but light pink really gives that feminine, playful kind of vibe.
Gay!
And that's really what it is. Because the theme of this video is about a scrub and me being annoyed with a scrub, I don't want to come across as too masculine. It's just, you know, he's bringing that side out of me. But naturally, my feminine aura is very, very cheeky, very playful, very sweet. And so that's what I want to bring across. And then I also have like a whole entire visual aspect that I'm going to show you guys later on in the video so you can see everything that I was inspired by and kind of where I'm mentally going with this. And then we're going to create it all here in this video. So you guys are basically just gonna be able to come with me and do all of this, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. So let's get the ball rolling. Guys, so right now I'm in my cute little office space. It's a little bit rusty right now, so I'm not gonna really show you guys what it looks like. We're gonna do something a little bit different. So if you guys have been watching any of my previous videos from this series, then you know that I have really been making a to-do list or a task in the corner of the screen, and I will just show you what I have to do in that video. Now, the only reason why I'm doing it different in this video is because we're planning a music video, and I want to show you guys exactly how I go about planning and just kind of keeping everything organized. So instead, my tasks are going to be on this software that I'm using, or it's not a software, it's a website or an app called Trello, and this is the saving grace of my life.
Yeah, boy.
It helps me keep organized and keep productivity, and honestly, it just makes sure that I have one central place to come and find everything that I'm working on. I'm going to screen record and show you guys on the other end. So this, my friends, is called Trello. So if I'm not looking at the camera, it's because I'm looking down here at my laptop. But this is my workspace right here. Now I want to just go over to boards so you guys can see all of my boards. So basically, this is kind of a little bit like Pinterest, if you will, where you can create your own boards and basically plug all of your ideas into one central place. But the difference is that this website is meant to increase productivity and making sure that you are not just staying organized, but working through and completing tasks. It's really, really easy for you to just think of everything that you have to do. But if you write it down and then you kind of have like an assembly line, it helps you to increase productivity, see where you're at, where you need to go and what you're currently doing. All of my boards are here. I use this to plan my meals. I use this to plan my content for Instagram, YouTube. I'm also using it for this series, and then I'm going to use it for this music video that we're working on. This is my workspace for Heart Inside is Safe. And as you can see, I have three different categories. I have my to-do list, I have doing, and then I have done. And there's a very strategic process to this. And obviously you can name it whatever you want, but this is what I have found works best for me. So the first thing on my to-do list is a video treatment. So as you can see, this is everything that I have to do for this entire video shoot. And what I can do is click this card. And when I go inside this card, I have all of the information that I need for that. So basically what I did initially is I created a document where I just put out all of my ideas. So it doesn't have to look like this. You can kind of just put like jot notes if you want to, but I like to do it like this so that I can kind of stay organized. So I have, you know, the specific song link, and then I also have an overview of kind of my idea and where I'm trying to go with this. And then I have the beginning, I have verse one, hook one, verse two, hook two, and so on and so forth, and any extra notes that I had there. This helped me to prepare and kind of organize what my thoughts and ideas were. And now that I have this document and I know kind of where I want to take the video, because I'm not well versed in a video treatment, I'm going to hire somebody who is. Now, if you don't know what a video treatment is, it's really just basically creating a theme or a script for the music video. So I went to Upwork, and basically what I did is I just typed in something about, like, you know, director or something like that, and then a bunch of people from Houston popped up. So I went to their profiles and I seen what they were able to do, and then I went ahead and I created a job posting. Now, this is one thing that I really, really, really like about Upwork. You can create your own job postings. There's other websites like Fiverr, but Upwork is very unique and they both serve their purpose, if you ask me. Like, some people will wonder which one is better. I think that it depends on what it is that you're looking for. So for Upwork, I really like to be able to post my own job postings, because instead of me having to reach out to people and this and that, they come to me and I'm able to set that budget. So when people apply for my job, they already know what they're going to get paid, and that's already settled. Whereas if you reach out to somebody, it's kind of like you have to go through a negotiation process. So I'm going to go to Upwork, I'm going to go to post a job, and this is, I'm going to show you guys exactly how I posted my job. So this is one portion that I want you guys to be careful about when you're posting a job, because I had a little bit of a run-in with this specific freelancer that I'm talking about right now, who did the video treatment for me. You know, she was very professional about it. It was just a little bit of a misunderstanding, but we got through it and that was perfectly fine. So what I'm going to do here is go to a short term, and everything that I do on here is very short term. I don't have, you know, a super booming business where I need to have employees consistently working every single day. So I prefer to just hire freelancers because it's quick little jobs that I need. So I do a short term, and then I click next, and then I'm going to write the title. So for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to say video treatment, but personally I like to make the title a little more detailed so that they can understand what they're doing. And then it will ask you the category. So let's just say video production. We go next to the skills. Now you can add up to 10 skills. I'm just gonna add one for the purpose of this video. We'll just say video production. If you scroll down, they have other categories that you can basically put filters and help your freelancer really know exactly what the job entails. So the next is going to be the scope. It's going to ask me, you know, small, medium, or large. This is just a small project. It's very straightforward. All I'm needing is somebody to help tie my video treatment together that I've already created. So then we move on to how long is this going to take. It's going to take less than a month. It's probably only going to take a couple hours at most. And then we want to figure out what level is this person on. Now, personally, I always go for intermediate. I don't go for expert, because expert usually tends to charge more because they're experts. And then entry level, it's like you're not necessarily going to get the best possible work. Keep it safe at intermediate. And then it says, is this job contract to hire? No, it's not. Contract to hire just basically means, oh, are you going to hire me after this contract for a permanent position? So I'm not doing that. And I go next to location. So I'm going to say US only. And then if I wanted to, I can put in time zones, like, or the state. So I could say Texas. And then I'll go next to my budget. Now, this is where I really want you guys to be careful, because this is what happened to me. And I don't want it to happen to you guys. So usually I just click project budget. And it's very, very important, because if I click a project budget, then I can tell them the max amount of money that I'm willing to spend on this project, which will usually be the amount of money that you're going to pay to them. Now, when you do hours, hourly rate. You say from what to what? What is the range? And then you guys will basically have a discussion on what the rate is actually going to be. Now, the problem with this is that on their end, once you hire them for this project and they're doing hourly, they can log as many hours as they want. Now, you can put a cap on it. You can say, you know, I only want them to work 40 hours a week, or I only want them to work 1 hour a week. I didn't know that that's what I accidentally clicked. And so what happened was, for the video treatment, she basically logged herself for 7.5 hours. So she wasn't even done the project when I noticed. And I was pretty taken aback by it. I was a little bit thrown off because it didn't even take me that long to create the document that I showed you guys previously. So I'm going to show you guys the document later, but she basically reiterated my ideas and just put it on a PowerPoint and made it look pretty. And I didn't necessarily need that. I actually told her the exact areas that I needed assistance with. And I wasn't happy about it. Now, I'm not going to name any names. I'm just not that type of person. I wish her all the best. I think it was just a little bit of a misunderstanding. And maybe our morals are a little bit different, because I don't think that she should have logged herself for 7.5 hours. I mean, $400 for a video treatment is just crazy to me. It's not like we're, you know, big superstars out here who are creating this great cinematic piece. We're trying to work within a budget and we're going cheap on this. So, you know, she basically was almost about to get paid for what the videographer is getting paid. Nonetheless, be careful with this, because now we go through a process of having to try and figure this out. So if you can't figure it out between you and the freelancer, then you're gonna have to dispute it. And with the dispute, it's like, you know, Upwork has to go through certain things and there's certain guidelines. And another thing too is that Upwork is kind of in the favor of the freelancer, because they say it's up to the freelancer's discretion if they want to refund you or not. Now, that's not to say that it's not going to affect them, because reviews and ratings are very important on Upwork, and people can see those reviews and ratings, and Upwork controls that. So if you have a bad experience with a seller, then you can go to their profile and leave a review about your experience and give them, you know, less stars. And that's going to probably show up first on their profile. You can have 100 good reviews, but that one bad review will really ruin your metrics. So that's why you want to be careful if you are a freelancer on here and making sure that your clients are happy. We decided that I was going to get refunded a portion of the money and she would keep a certain portion, and we were able to settle it on our end instead of having to go through the dispute process. So next, you want to click the budget and then you put in your budget. So say I want to do like $500 or whatever for the video treatment. My budget, that's another thing. My budget for the video treatment, y'all, was $50. And she wasn't even done at $375 later of what she logged herself, which means that I would have had to pay her more than $371 if I didn't say anything. Anyways, so let's just say $50 is the budget, and then we're gonna go to the description. Now, here is where you really, really wanna get detailed about what the project is going to entail. I like to make sure that I include any files or links that are going to be necessary, and I kinda try and make it a business document so it looks easy to read, like titles, captions, bullet points, anything that's going to help them digest the information better. And then once you're done doing all of that, you can go ahead and click review job, and then you're done, and you can post it, and it posts right away. And then just wait until the applications roll in. And that's pretty much how I did my Upwork posting for my video treatment. Okay, friends, so this is the video treatment that she created for me. She really stuck with the theme, with the pink cutesy kind of vibes. And you kind of just go through each slide and you see the inspiration for everything. And there's also like a music video that I'm really inspired by called You Never Met a Quite Like Me by Kid Rock. So y'all probably don't know that song, but nonetheless, Pamela Anderson is in it. So I'm just gonna go over here to YouTube to show you guys exactly what I'm talking about, my inspiration for the video. Remember, this song is on the mixtape Never Mind, I'll Do It Myself. So we kind of want to stick within that theme. So you're gonna see me doing things myself, like I'm gonna be like Pamela Anderson, painting my toenails or doing my laundry, cooking, whatever. I'm doing things myself. So this right here is the part that I'm kind of inspired by. You see she's painting her toenails. And then she kind of turns around and she looks at him. And that's gonna be how I'm gonna do. I'm gonna look at him, but I'm gonna be so annoyed with him. Like, she's just kind of blah. And I'm gonna be like,
do me a favor, please. Get out of here. Get out of here, man. Shit, I'm saying.
Attitude, just so grossed out by him, just so over him, like, boy, get out of here kind of thing. If you continue to watch this video, you'll just see, like, he's the artist in the video, so you're not really gonna see too much of his personality. But if you scroll here to the beginning, when he wakes up, or when he gets up for the day and he comes outside, oh, he scratches his crotch right here. Here we go. Okay. So that's going to be like his character, except my actor is probably going to play it up a lot more because we really want to go with the extra aspect. So this is the treatment, and she just kind of goes every single slide and goes into detail about each scene and how it's going to be. You guys are going to see all of this come together, but basically, like, I'm going to kick him out. I'm going to be like talking to the camera as if I'm talking to him, yelling at him, like, tap in my shoulder while you sleep. I ain't your freak. The fuck? Then when I kick him out, I'm also going to be on the phone talking to myself. So it's going to be me in a whole different outfit, whole different room. And my ad libs are going to be one person. And then my main rap is going to be another person. But obviously, it's all going to be me, just different outfits. So basically, I'm going to be talking on the phone. And my ad libs are basically going to be me hyping myself up. So I'm just like rapping. And then when I do my ad libs, that's going to be the other character. And I'm just going to be like, yeah, that's right, girl. Yeah. And then me, I'm going to be rapping like, yeah, this guy's so whack. Like, oh my gosh, girl. So just picture it like that. And then, you know, we have other scenes where I'm going to be like wearing a different outfit, golf club, this, that, whatever. There's going to be, you know, other scenes when I'm in the kitchen and I'm going to kind of cook him up like a poisonous meal or make him a poisonous drink kind of thing. And then because I'm going to have all these different outfits on, we're going to do kind of like a collage, and you can basically just see every single outfit, me rapping to the camera and being cute and whatever. So that's just going to be the vibe of the video. So I hope y'all like it. But let us go back to Trello. I need to rent out the studio. So here we can come to this board, and if you click on the cover photo, you get to see visuals of the actual studio that I rented. This is gonna be one of the scenes when I'm in the bedroom laying on the bed, like he might come over and like try and get a little something. I'm like, boy, please. And then this is gonna be the kitchen, so it's gonna be kind of like I'm serving him, you know what I'm saying? But I'm serving him that poisonous meal. And there's gonna be, that's the cell phone. Y'all already know the old school cell phone, but it's super cute and vibey. I'm gonna be talking on that one. So anyways, those are the photos. So if you scroll down, I actually included the booking website. Now, Trello did not pay me because they don't have an affiliate program to promote them. Peerspace does though. So if you guys enjoy my videos and you like what I'm doing, if you wanna support me, you can definitely click the link in the description box, and you'll also get $50 off of your first purchase on Peerspace. Anyways, if you look on here on Peerspace, it's super easy to use. I'm gonna show you guys real quickly how to use it, but this is the booking that I have, and it's here in Houston. And you know, if you scroll down, you can see all of the details of the property, and it even has like a map to show you what area. It's not gonna give you the location until you actually book, but you can see what area it's actually in, and it will show you their operating hours and all this other information that's important. And they also have reviews. The thing that I like about Peerspace is that it kind of reminds me of like Airbnb. So when you go to the search engine and you're looking for a studio, it's going to ask you, what are you planning? So for the purpose of this video, I'm planning a photo shoot. And then I'm gonna go in and tell them that I want it in Houston, or I can put the zip code, but Houston is just better because I get to see like everything that's in Houston. And now look. This screen comes up with a bunch of different thumbnails. You can kind of scroll and see like the best pictures, and you can click on the profile if you like it. And then on the right hand side, you get to also see a map and all of the different places and their locations and what areas that they're actually in. I'm gonna sit here and just go scroll through, and if I like something, I can click the heart, and then I can add it to one of my playlists here. One of my boards. I just add it and click save. And then that's good enough. And then if I'm working with a team of people like I am, I can invite them by email to look at the booking. So that's really it, guys, how I use that. And these people are pretty, I've had great experiences so far using Peerspace. These people are really good about messaging back right away. This is the space that I booked. And if you guys want to book this space, it's called the Pink Playhouse. Click the link in the description box and you're gonna get $50 off your first purchase on Peerspace. Now, let's go back to our inspiration. So this is going to be where I'm going to be painting my own toenails, and he walks inside. So I'm gonna show you guys the fit. I know I probably should wait until the end, but I'm going to show you guys the inspiration for every single fit. So let's go.
A few moments later.
Okay, y'all, this is outfit one. If you remember in the inspiration video of Pamela Anderson and Kid Rock, Pamela Anderson was wearing like a pink lingerie outfit, and she kind of had like these big cloggy heels like I have on. I absolutely love this outfit. I think I got it for like probably a little over $100 from Christina the Bikini Lady, or no,
On Instagram, her name is Sexy Bikini Lady Christina. Tell her that I'm the one who sent you if you buy anything from her. She is one of my favorites. She also makes outfits as well. She's made me a really, really sexy gown before. It's like a lingerie kind of piece, but either way, she always sells like cute bathing suit outfits or like lingerie kind of pieces. But this one is super girly, super cheeky. Okay, friends, this is outfit number two. This one I'm going to actually wear in the kitchen. So this is gonna be where I'm cooking up his poisonous meal. And I'm thinking that I might get an apron or something like cute just to indicate that I'm like a server or whatever. But as you can see, it's very classy. It's giving red because that's the theme of the kitchen. And I absolutely love it. This is one of my favorite dresses. I think I got this from Shein or Fashion Nova. I don't know. And I probably paid like no more than 35, 25 bucks for this. So yeah, this is the fit. Okay, this has got to be my favorite outfit of them all. It's kind of hard for you guys to see, I know. But this inspiration I actually got from Pinterest. There was this kind of collage, and I feel like it's a lady off of a television show. I'm going to show you guys right here on the screen. But anyways, this is like an early 2000s vibe that I wanted to go for. I just thought it was super cute. And I'm going to probably have like a clip, like some blinged out clip in the side of my hair. But yeah, this is the fit. And I'm going to also accessorize it as well. I'm going to come a little bit closer so that you guys can see. I'm probably going to have to put like nipple stickers on and stuff like that. Now, I don't really have a price on the fit because these pants, I'm pretty sure my mom gave to me. And this shirt I got from Shein, it was probably like $5. Shein is so cheap, you already know. But these heels that I have, I got them along with a matching purse. I'll show you guys as well. These were handmade. They spent a lot of money on them. I think I spent like $700 on these handmade heels. They are like the best quality heels that I think I have. Let me see if I can find. Yes, here's the purse. This is the matching purse. Now, I'm not gonna wear the matching purse in the thing. I'll probably take pictures with it and maybe bring the matching purse, but for the video, I don't need to have all of that, but I just wanted to let y'all know kind of what the pricing was for this fit. The pants, my mom shops cheap, so I bet you any money she didn't spend more than $10 on the pants, I swear. There's this place in Toronto called Orpheus Road. She used to take me there all the time when I was a kid growing up. Y'all, when I say budget, go there. Outfit number four, guys. This is such a cute, classy, sexy outfit. It's kind of giving Paris Hilton or like Rich Valley Girl or like Louis Vuitton, like let's go shopping. I don't know. Anyways, this is what it's giving. And I also have a white dog. You guys, actually, I got white dogs in my room. I'll show you guys later. But anyways, I'm probably just going to have this vibe, y'all. So these are the four fits. I hope you guys like them. Let me know in the comments below which one is your favorite fit.
Anyways, y'all, I wanted to show you my little doggy. So this is the fitty fit. Rich daddy's girl.
So the next thing that I want to do is hire a videographer. So I'm basically just gonna do the exact same thing that I did when I did the video treatment. Another thing that I like to do as well is look at the actual people in Houston or people that are close to me, and then I'll come and I'll invite them to my job posting. Now, not all the time do people respond, but nonetheless, when I go to Upwork, if you go to all job posts, and then if you scroll down, it says film music video in Houston, Texas. That's the job posting that I posted. If you scroll down, you'll see everybody here that applied. And then you can go to messages, so all the people that actually I was in communication with. And as you can see, this is the guy right here, the best match that it says, Tom C. And him and I were in communication. And the thing that I like about Upwork is that I can go to his profile and see everything. But also, he sent me a cover letter and he went really into detail. So I got to know him a little bit and he made me feel really comfortable. He sent me some of his previous work that he's done, which was great. Then I messaged him. Him and I had some good communication. And then we got off the platform. He gave me his number and we spoke on the phone. And if you scroll down, you can see his profile and you can see his portfolio. You can see his reviews and the things that people are saying about him. And another thing that I like, it's not on this page, but if you actually just click somebody's profile when you're just like searching in the search engine, you can actually see their job success rate. So you can see how many jobs are they actually completing and if they're having success with the clients that they're working with and if people are actually liking them. So you really get to know this person just based off their profile alone. So this is the person that I hired for this project. So literally all I have to do is just click hire. So So the next thing that I need to do is hire a photographer, y'all. So I actually haven't found a photographer yet. So I'm just gonna do the exact same thing that I did with the video treatment and that I did with the videographer. I'm gonna create a job posting and hopefully somebody reaches out to me. I'm not looking for somebody that's going to take great cinematic pictures. I just want something that's simple, like a little here and there, probably have them there for an hour, and that should be good to go.
Captain of the ship, let's take a trip. Don't tell me no, cause that's the quickest way that you could go back to your hoes. These niggas for the streets, get the fuck up out my piece. Guess I'm Kiki Meech the Beast. Like I said, these niggas weak. Tapping my shoulder while I sleep, I ain't your free. You want some head, I ain't no geek, get out my sheath. Matter of fact, boy, run me them keys. I finesse and take it all, you ain't got shit, so let me be. Go!
Okay, so I posted the job for hiring a photographer, so I put that into the doing folder, and then I'm going to need some camera equipment. So the person that is going to be recording for me actually needs some lighting. And I think that that's all the equipment that he really asked me to rent. So I'm going to rent from Photo Rental Source. If you remember back in the Ball and Shoot, that's where I rented from before. And they were really helpful. So I'm just going to really call them. And I'm just going to ask them a few questions. Yeah, I'll put them on speaker.
Photo Rental Source.
Hi, I'm just calling because I would like to rent some lighting. I'm not too familiar with what kind of lighting I need. I'm just shooting a music video. It's gonna be a quick 3-hour shoot, but we did wanna get some lighting in there. So do you have any suggestions on what we could use?
We have a few different types of video lights. When would you need to pick them up so I can see what we'll have available?
Friday.
So as far as availability, we have 2 of the ePhotos, we have 2 of the Amaran 200s, mm-hmm. We have 6 of the RGB P60C panels available.
Do I have to rent for a certain amount of days?
Well, if you go to our website, they're underneath the video lighting category. That's where they're located.
Okay.
And they do come with, each one of them comes with a light stand. And basically, we have different rates. So if you need it over the weekend, like Friday, like pick up Friday and return on Monday, mm-hmm. You can do the weekend rate.
Okay, so I can just go ahead and book online then.
Exactly. Yeah.
Perfect. So should I get multiple lights or is one enough? Yeah, it's not going to be a lot of moving around, and it's only going to be, there's going to be 2 people, but the main subject is just 1 person, and it will be kind of stationary.
Okay, I mean, you could get by with 1, but, you know, 2 always helps cancel out shadows, so
okay.
Keep that in mind.
Okay, perfect. Well, thank you so much for your help. That was very informative.
Yeah, if you have any other questions, we're here until 6 today.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
All right, take care. Bye.
Y'all, I'm on my way to my lip appointment. It's about, what time is it? It's like 12 o'clock. So my appointment's at 1. I'm about 45 minutes away. I've gotten my lips done before. It wears off after a while. I didn't really like my results the first time. I felt like I wanted it to be a little more... But we'll see what she... I'm using a different product today, and I heard really good stuff about it in comparison to the other product that I used. I used Juvederm the first time, and this time I'm using Vercella. Or a Versa. But anyways, guys, let's go to this lip appointment. Okay, y'all, I literally just got here. I'm like walking upstairs. It's such a nice area. I feel like I'm in River Oaks area, but I'm not entirely sure. So how many weeks does it take to heal, like fully heal?
2 weeks.
2 weeks?
So if you have stuff going on, you can apply lipstick tomorrow.
Okay.
But make sure you're icing it when you're at home.
I have a video shoot tomorrow, so I'm like, maybe tomorrow will be a little bit swollen so they get like a little juice.
Tomorrow.
Okay, I want them to be bigger though. Good. I'm trying to go extra, like everything's extra for the shoot.
And then I'm gonna go ahead and apply the anesthesia. Are you allergic to lidocaine?
No, okay. I used it last time. So these are the lips. They look so good. Honestly, the only thing that I don't like is I like smoke blunts.
And y'all, it's kind of darker right around here. No, here. Let me know in the comments if y'all have like a lip scrub or something that you could recommend, because I don't like the way it looks. But other than that, don't they look so good, y'all? They're gonna blow up a little bit more and then they're gonna go down. So tomorrow at my video shoot, they're probably gonna look extra plump, which I won't, because you know your girl's trying to come through looking cute. But anyways, I gotta go pay. So it's out. Okay, y'all, so now I actually have to go meet up with the videographer. He's coming in from out of town. He doesn't live here, but his girlfriend does. So he's gonna be spending a couple weeks here, and he's seen my ad on Upwork. So we're going to link up today. He just got in yesterday. So now I'm gonna go to a Starbucks somewhere and meet up with him. I'm just walking down the stairs from the spa. So I'm gonna go meet up with him. I'm just gonna show him the video treatment and kind of give him a rundown of how the day is gonna look. We have 4 hours.
Oh my God.
I'm hoping to get the video shoot done in 3. I kind of feel like maybe I'm in over my head. You know, you learn as you go, and this is the fun thing about it. So I'm just walking to my car right now. My lips are pretty numb, y'all. I'm just going to bump my music in the car, but I'll catch y'all on the flip side. Don't mind my hair, okay? Yes, I'm going to go get it done. That's the next thing on my to-do list. But y'all, listen to this. The lady who does my toes is like my favorite nail tech in the whole entire world. She always comes through. She always is on point. She literally will file you down to the T. She makes sure that she gets that shape on point. The vibe is good. She gives you a great massage, pedicure on point. Y'all, my toes, they look amazing.
Tap in my shoulder while I sleep. I ain't your freak. You want some head? I ain't no geek, get on my sheets. Matter of fact, boy, run me them keys. I finesse and take it all. You ain't got shit, so let me be. Go. Who let these niggas out the house? Put them back in the kennel. Who let these niggas out the house? Put them back, put them back, put them back.
Definitely go follow my girl on Instagram. Her name is Eldris Nailed It on Instagram. Literally every single time she's ever done my toenails, guys, I've always been so impressed. She gonna make sure that she gets you right. She gonna make sure that she got a nice color. And if she don't got the color, she'll mix colors together. That's how we achieve this, baby. Look at this. It's gonna be the perfect look for the video shoot. Y'all are going to love this video shoot. I promise you, I'm so excited. Ah!
Who let these niggas out the house? Put them back in the kennel. Who let these niggas out the house? Put them back, put them back, put them back. Who let these niggas out the house? Mm-mm-mm. Who let these niggas out the house? Mm-mm-mm-mm.
My hairstylist canceled on me.
No, God, please, no, no, no.
But luckily, I was able to find somebody else who can do my hair now. Basically, what I got done was a sew-in. I was just gonna get her to touch it up, but she canceled on me. So I found somebody who said that they'll touch it up for me, even though it's not their work. Thank God for this woman. Ooh, I'm so excited. So I just got here to the place. I still got probably 20 minutes to wait. And then after that, I have my makeup appointment. And then after that, I have the studio at 6 p.m. So I'm hoping that I can get everything done in a timely manner. I already went and ran some errands, and I got my antifreeze. That's the poison that I'm gonna cook up for the dusty little scrub. I also got nail polish remover, nail polish. What else did I get? That's it. So everything seems like it's going on track. So I'm really happy about that, because earlier I was devastated, y'all. I was freaking out. I was on my way home. I had already messaged somebody to see if they could do my hair. And then I was on my way home and I was like, I'm just gonna do my hair myself. So then she actually texted me back as I was driving, and I was like, oh great. So she was like, yeah, I can get you in for 2, and boom boom bam, and you already know your girl is clean. And it actually worked out in my favor, because the lady who was supposed to do my hair, she said that tomorrow she'll do my hair for free.
Yes, yes.
Remember I told y'all that I'm gonna record more footage at another studio, so I'm gonna have 2 different hairstyles, and I don't even have to be the one to do it. Oh my goodness, the Lord is looking out for your girl. Anyway, y'all, I'm gonna go get this hair done, so let's go. Okay, y'all, I literally just finished getting my hair done. Now I'm on my way to my makeup appointment. I'm driving, so I can't really vlog like that. But as you can see, your girl did a really good job. I'm gonna make sure that I tag her as well so that you guys can see her page and her work. She's here in Houston, very professional. She squeezed me in, and oh gosh, I just love her. I'm gonna go get my hair done by her again. But anyways, I'm gonna see y'all in a minute when my makeup is beat. Peace out. Y'all, I made it. I'm finally here. I'm in my outfit. So I have to take some pictures right now, but my makeup's done. It looks bad as hell. I mean, bad mean good. The photographer been here waiting for me, so I'm about to go and get these shots. My homie Melvin is here. Okay, Melvin, take over.
It's good, y'all. What's up, bro?
My name is Kiki Nijoni. Don't know I'm a rapper. I'm from Toronto, but I'm here in Houston. Ow!
Beats by Rafiq.
And this is my man for the day. Tell him what your name is.
How y'all doing? My name's Ten. Ten Shogun. I'm a rapper, sound engineer, actor.
And you didn't even get a freestyle up on here, but we don't got time.
I know. We don't have time.
This time's gonna be the last time that we worked together. We had a good little vibe, didn't we?
For sure. We need to do like a song or something together.
Something. Mm-hmm. And he said he's an engineer. You know I'm gonna be in that studio singing, okay? Yep. So y'all, we are finished. We're about to get going. It's about 10 o'clock. Tom is over here tired. He ready to go to bed. But this was the videographer. He did such an amazing job. I cannot wait for you guys to see everything that we worked on. And we're definitely gonna be working together again, right?
I guess so.
Well, tomorrow. But moving forward in the future, I feel like we definitely made a good team. And you know, he does more than just video. He does photography, he does editing. So y'all make sure that you hit him up. You already know I'm gonna link him down in the description box.
Thank you.
I think that what I learned for this shoot is I need more time. More people means more time. And I only booked it for 4 hours because the last time, y'all remember when I did Ballin, I booked it for like 4 or 5 hours and it was just way too long. But this time it was like there was a lot more going on. We had the photographer, we had the other actor that was here, and then we also had multiple scenes that I was supposed to get in different outfits. So we didn't end up getting all the footage that I wanted to get, but that's fine because, you know, I'm really rocking with Tom as a videographer and he's definitely down to get more footage. So we're probably going to do another session. It's going to be super quick this time though, and it's just going to be like 2 outfits, some B-roll, and that's good to go. So far from what we've seen and what we got, we're really, really happy with it. And I think that you guys are going to love it. I can't wait to get this video edited and just see where it goes. Yay!
Who let these niggas out the house? I ain't talking SWV when I say these niggas weak. I left my heart inside a safe. Won't get the coke cause you like to cheat. Call me a freak, but you can't get to taste. My cream is sweet. Drop to your knees. I like it when my niggas tell me please. I'm a boss, captain of the ship. Let's take a trip. Don't tell me no, cause that's the quickest way that you could go back to your hoes. These niggas for the streets. Get the fuck up on my piece. Guess I'm Kiki Meets the Beast. Like I said, these niggas weak. Tapping my shoulder while I sleep, I ain't your free. You want some head, I ain't no geek, get out my sheets. Matter of fact, boy, run me them keys. I finesse and take it all, you ain't got shit, so let me be. Go! Who let these niggas out that house? Put them back in the kennel. Who let these niggas out that house? Put them back, put them back, put them back. Who let these niggas out that house? Who let these niggas out that house? Let a bitch try me, I'm losing my cool. These niggas ain't got no loot, you crazy if you let them fuck on you. I ain't gon' let a nigga get inside of my pants if he ain't got money like that. I'm too turned up in the cut, getting paid to look cute. That's a fact, my baby, look boo, eat trans.